debts can be raised from various sources. An organization can raise debt by issuing bonds. Bonds are basically the long-term instruments which can be used or issued by government, or it can be issued by public sector units. And the other form of debt is debenture. The debentures are generally issued by private sector companies. And third form of debt is bank loan, and bank loans are issued by or raised by all business units. See, the bonds and debentures have certain features. First is, they are issued at a value, and the original value is called as face value or par value, and only on this value interest is applied or interest is calculated, and this interest would be agreed in an agreement, and that is called as coupon rate, and that is also tax deductible. And these borrowings will have a maturity, and on the expiry of the maturity period they have to be repaid, and they will also have a redemption value. It means the value that has to be paid on maturity, which can be at par or it can be at premium or it can also be at discount. And sometimes these instruments will also have market value. It means they are traded in stock exchanges. Let's see cost of debentures. Cost of debentures is nothing but the interest that has been agreed for borrowing or raising funds through debentures, and it is basically the after tax rate. So let's understand what is this after tax rate. Let's say there is a company called X and it has earnings before interest and tax of 100, and they have to pay interest. So for that, I'll give the borrowing detail. They have debentures of 100 which was borrowed at 10%. So interest is going to be 100 multiplied by 10%, it is 10. So we have interest is 10. So from EBIT we are deducting interest, which is 10. So we have PBT of 90. On this PBT of 90, let's say tax have to be paid at 30%. So less tax at 30% on 90, it is going to be 27. So now we have profit after tax of 63. So this as we'll call this as scenario 1. So the tax paid in scenario 1 is 27. Now we'll take scenario 2, where the company has same EBIT but they don't have any borrowings. It means they don't have any debentures. So EBIT is same 100, they are not going to pay any interest. So PBT is also going to be 100, and on this 100 they have to pay tax at 30%, which is 30, and the profit after tax with them is 70. So in scenario 2, the tax that has been paid by this company is 30. So if you compare scenario 1 and 2, in scenario 2 they have paid excess tax of 3, and that has not happened in scenario 1. That's mainly because of tax shield which the company had on tax of 3 because of interest. So what is the tax shield? It is 3. If you compare here, the tax that has been paid is 27 for same level of EBIT, and here the tax that has been paid is 30. So the difference of 3 is the tax shield which the company has earned in scenario 1 because of presence of interest. So the interest cost is nothing but the cost which is after the tax rate. So here we'll have interest is nothing but 10% multiplied by after tax rate, and here the tax rate was 30%, so multiplied by 70%, so it is 1 minus 0.3. so 10% into 0.7, the effective interest rate is 7%. So what do we understand? Cost of debt is nothing but interest rate multiplied by after tax rate. So KD is equal to interest rate multiplied by 1 minus T.